Anime! Hello everyone, my name is Derek and welcome back to Anime on the Netflix Know-How. Today we have Castlevania, a Netflix original anime series based on the iconic video game franchise of the same name. Castlevania takes place in the fictional country of Wallachia, where its citizens are being hunted down by demonic hordes summoned by Dracula after the church thought it would be a good idea to kill Dracula's wife. Yeah, that seems fair. The story follows Trevor Belmont, last son of the infamous demon-hunting Belmont clan, as he fights off the monsters sent by Dracula to protect the people of Wallachia. Now right off the bat, I was skeptical about this anime, not necessarily because I was expecting it to be bad, but because film and television adaptations of video game series have, well, they don't exactly have the best track record up to this point. Thankfully, Castlevania managed to be a pretty pleasant surprise. I mean, it's not a perfect series by any means, it definitely has its flaws. A whole lot of them, if I'm going to be completely honest. First of all, it's an incredibly short series, running only 4 episodes, with each episode being only roughly 23 minutes long. The entire series comes out to just about an hour and a half, which is incredibly short. Now, having a short length for a series is not a problem if you're doing something like a miniseries, which I initially thought this was going to be, but it's not. These 4 initial episodes are actually more like a glorified prologue to a bigger story. It's kind of like starting a role-playing video game where the world has to be established and all of the backstory has to be explained and all of these different characters have to be introduced so that you can add them to your party, all in preparation for a much bigger story that is going to come. This is exactly what season 1 of Castlevania is, and it ends right at the part where all of the good stuff is about to start happening. To be honest, these 4 episodes feel like they should have been condensed into maybe an hour-long episode that would have served as the opening for the series, and then it should have just continued on after that. But for whatever reason, they just split the opening episode into 4 little pieces and then forgot to make the rest of it. There isn't a feeling of resolution or any sense of finality once you reach the end of the series because the story's basically just starting, nothing really important has happened yet. The pacing is also really weird, and it feels like there's a lot of events and details that are just kind of skipped over. Like, there's this weird disconnect between the very first episode and the other 3 episodes that happen after it. So the first episode is where we are introduced to Dracula, and we're given all of the backstory about him meeting his wife, and then she ends up getting killed by the church, and that motivates him to bring down this plague of demons to hunt down humanity. And that's all really good and well, and Dracula even seems like a really cool and complex villain, but then we never hear from him for the rest of the series. The first episode also ends on this really intense cliffhanger, and it's not brought up again until the very end of the last episode, and it's just weird because it's like skips this whole thing that happened in between and we're just supposed to accept that. We are basically told that something happened and then we are never actually shown what happened. Come to think of it, there's actually a whole lot of telling us things in this series and not a whole lot of showing them, which for a series or a film or any sort of visual medium like that is a huge no-no. This is most notable when characters are talking about the Belmont family because they are constantly bringing up like what the Belmont family did. You know, they hunted down these monsters, they practiced dark magic, they got exiled from the community because they thought they were, you know, going to be bad luck and bad juju for the people of Wallachia. But we're never actually shown any of this, we're just told it. It's always like this close-up dramatic shot of a person who's like, the Belmont family did bad things, they hunted demons, this is their fault. Like, that's all well and good, but can you show us some of this? Like, this family is awesome. Why are you not showing us any of the cool things that they did? There's also a lot of exposition as a result of this, and since we're just being fed it to us through characters talking to the camera, it's not very exciting. They even went to the trouble of animating this really cool and badass title sequence in the very first episode, and then they never use it again. They just use it in the very first one. There are some other smaller problems and nitpicks about this series that I could talk about, but you get the general idea. It is a heavily flawed show. But you know what? I still liked it. I'll be completely honest, I liked it a lot more for the potential that it presents in the following seasons than what it currently is right now. But it is a very good start. The animation is really dark and stylish, and it's just full of these shadows and high contrast, and it just oozes this sense of gothic broodiness, and I love it. The action is genuinely exciting and choreographed beautifully, and it's super bloody and gory, which I loved because, I mean, it's based on a video game where you hunt monsters and fight Dracula. It's got to be bloody and gory and sort of gruesome. It also has these really deep and strong themes of the hubris of religion and the consequences of blind obedience and what that leads to. But by far the best aspect of this series is Trevor Belmont. He is such an entertaining protagonist. He's voiced by Richard Armitage, and if you don't know who this guy is, if you go watch the Hobbit movies, there's this one particular person who is the leader of the dwarves named Thorin Oakenshield. That's him. The Hobbit movies were terrible, by the way, and I know this is completely unrelated, but Richard Armitage as Thorin was fantastic, and he is even better as Trevor Belmont in this Castlevania show. Trevor Belmont is a dry, sarcastic, quick-witted asshole who hates humanity almost as much as Dracula does, and for very good reason. I mean, if you think about it, both of them had very important things taken away from them by humanity and the church. For Dracula, that was his wife, and for Trevor Belmont, it was his entire family. So they both have a reason to kind of want all of humanity to die. I mean, everything that happens to them is completely the church's fault, and everyone just kind of followed suit, but I understand where they're both coming from. I just love Trevor Belmont so much because he is such a jackass. I mean, the way that we're introduced to his character is in a drunken bar fight. And it's not even a fight where he, like, handily kicks everyone's butt because, you know, he's this great warrior. He gets the crap kicked out of him. He still wins, but it's like just a drunken brawl. And this is how we're introduced to this character. It's fantastic. Even though he's really jaded and blatantly hates everyone and everything, he still has empathy and compassion, particularly for the innocent. And that is the key to his humanity and what makes him better than Dracula. Plus, I mean, he's a Belmont. He's a total badass. God damn, that's a cool whip. I just love this character. He is really funny and really sarcastic, and his bitter cynicalness is honestly something that I can really relate to. So, despite its flaws, and there are a lot of them, I'm going to give Castlevania a thumbs up. I know that it's not a complete story at all, and that is honestly its biggest flaw, but it did get me excited to continue watching this series and see what is going to come. So in that regard, I consider it a success. I just really wish I knew why they chose to break up the series in this weird fashion. It doesn't make any sense to me, so I really hope that the following seasons deliver. Castlevania may be missing a few crucial body parts, but it's still a bloody good time. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate every single one of you. So yeah, I enjoyed Castlevania quite a bit, even though it definitely had a lot of problems. And for some of you, those problems might be too big to overcome and you won't end up liking it. But for what it is and what they're going for, I think they did a good job. And so I'm definitely going to be tuning in for season 2, which is supposed to come out at some point this year. Anyway, if you enjoyed this content, be sure to hit that subscribe button down below and share it with all your friends. I would really appreciate that. You can also head over to Twitter and over to Facebook and follow me on there. And as always, if you want to know your flicks, you know where to click. Happy hunting, guys. I'll see you next time.